Hi there, this is Ruben for Sonokinetic, and in this tutorial video I'm going to take a look at Grosso's transition builder. The builder is a completely separate patch unique to Grosso, and it features a scripting engine which will automatically build brass and woodwind crescendi based on various chords. The patch also contains a whole host of percussion fills and a multi-sampled taiko ensemble which can be used to embellish the various transitions. So let's take a look at how it works. This is the main interface for the transition builder, and it's really similar to the main Grosso patches with a few notable differences. You've got four presets you can choose. Either click them or just use the key switches at the bottom here. Each one of these fields can be assigned to brass or woodwinds, and you can choose the various different chord builds just by clicking on them. And there's also different variations for each one. Now I'll just explain these in a little bit more detail. Basically, this is a graphical representation of the chord intervals that are building up throughout the crescendo. So let me give an example. I'll play just a very simple one to begin with. So this one's going to play a root note and then an octave interval. And I'll play a C major. So that one's very simple, but obviously these become more complex. So let's say, for example, this one, which is the most complex one. This is the order in which the intervals are added, and you've got variations. You'll see how these numbers change as you choose the different variations. So if I play C major on this one, for example, you'll hear the intervals as they're introduced. This is exactly the same for the woodwinds. And there's a general rule of thumb with these. The variations to the left-hand side are more basic, firsts, thirds, fifths, and eighths. And as you move more to the right, they become more esoteric, 13ths, 7ths, that kind of thing. So there's one other option within the field here, and that's this little note here. Now this can be changed from dotted crotchet to crotchet and dotted minim. And all this is how quickly the notes are introduced in relation to your door's BPM. You can hear it's much quicker there with the dotted minim. The lengths of the transitions within the builder are between 3 and 4 bars long, depending on the complexity of the patterns. But these can be cut short prematurely if you'd like. Just release the notes and you'll get a release chord. Or alternatively, you can go into contact and stop the tempo syncing. And then you can adjust the BPM to choose whichever speed you'd like. Well, so far I've just been playing C major, but just like the normal Grosso patches, all 12 root keys are available. And you can also play in inversions. The real big difference between the Grosso transition builder and the normal Grosso patches is that with the normal patches you can only play major and minor triads, but with the transition builder there's many more different chord shapes available, and that's unique to the builder. There's a full list in the manual of all the different chords you can play and the triads you'll need to hit to do so. So there's major, minor, dominant sevenths, diminished, half diminished, augmented and suspended. I'll just give you a couple of examples for those. Half diminished, for example. And let's try a different variation with the dominant seventh. Just be aware that with some of the simpler chord builds, you may not be able to hear all of the intervals of a particularly complex chord, so you'll just need to choose a more complex pattern. So that's the tonal aspects of the percussion builder, but we haven't yet touched on any of these upper keys here, and they're all percussion samples. Now the exact layout of these is explained in the manual, but you can also hit the info button here and that will tell you exactly what you've got. Percussion fills on these green keys here, and then individual taiko hits that are mapped out in octaves so that you can play them with two hands. There's also taiko ensemble samples, and flams. And there's a few sticks and grand casa there thrown in for good measure. So let's look briefly at the options within the transition builder. Most of these are very similar to the ones that you've got in the normal Grosso patches. There's volume, which you can drag up and down just to adjust the individual fields. You've got panning of fields, drag left and right. There's percussion specific level and panning, and this will adjust the relative percussion levels and panning in relation to the chords. Various different mic positions. 2T is our mixed position, but you've also got individual mics, close, deca, wide and far. And the standard tuning options as well. So let's see what the transition builder can do in action. I've prepared a short clip here, and there's two transition chords and plenty of percussion to drive the rhythm and embellish the chords. And I'm also going to use some strings and woodwind on a separate channel. Let's hear it. For more information about the Transition Builder or any other aspect of Grosso, please check out the manual or our support page at support.sonokinetic.net. Don't forget to check out the other Grosso videos, and thanks for watching.